Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome into the LakersNation.com YouTube channel. Make sure you do subscribe and don't forget to turn on notifications. The Lakers do not waste much time filling Jason Kidd's spot on the bench, bringing in David Fizdale. Joining me to discuss it is Matt Peralta from LakersNation.com. Matt, how are you doing, man? And are you surprised by this hire?
Take that for data, Trevor. This hiring is not surprising at all. There's a lot of ties with David Fizdale to players and people in the current organization. Also, as an LA guy, so I think he ticks off a few boxes that the Lakers were looking for in an assistant head coach. So it remains to be seen what he'll exactly be responsible for. But on paper, the hiring makes sense.
I mean, a lot of people will point to his record as a head coach, which was not good. Had one successful season where he was just barely above 500 in his first season with Memphis Grizzlies, then three losing seasons in a row, one with the Grizzlies, two with the New York Knicks. Both of his head coaching stints so far lasted about a year and a half, and then he was let go by the teams that hired him on. So a lot of people will point to those situations as reason why the Lakers maybe didn't bring in the right guy. But you talked a little bit off air about pace and space and what Fizdale tried to bring into the Memphis Grizzlies. How can that apply to the Lakers?
Yeah, so David Fizdale is largely credited for the Miami Heat switching their offense over to a pace and space offense. And that happened when they won those two titles in 2012 and 2013. I think he was brought into Memphis because, remember, they were the grit and grind Grizzlies for a long time, and they brought David Fizdale in there to change up their entire offense. So from a Lakers standpoint, I think this means that they'll be adopting a more modern offense. We saw a lot of post-ups last season with LeBron James and Anthony Davis, and for good reason, because those two players are really good at it. But I think as an entire scheme or an entire philosophy offensively, I think we'll see more pacing. I think we'll see, you know, LeBron James or the other ball handlers trying to get up more in transition. We'll see more spacing principles. We'll see them take and attempt more three-pointers. I know the percentage wasn't great last year, but I think, you know, volume will help make that up a little bit. So I'm interested to see how that works. But I think overall, you know, a lot of Lakers fans have been clamoring for an offensive-minded assistant head coach to pair with Frank Vogel. I think David Fizdale fits that mold. We have to remember, even though he has been out of the game for a couple of years now as a head coach, he's had time to, you know, learn, study the modern NBA, see, you know, how he could affect a team. And I think, you know, I'm really interested to see how this affects the Lakers because, again, we harped on the offensive a lot. So here's your offensive coordinator. Let's see what he can do with the Lakers.
How much of a factor do you think the relationship with LeBron is? The fact that he already coached LeBron in Miami, I would imagine LeBron had to have signed off on this. Like, obviously he was consulted here. It feels like a very LeBron-centric move to bring in Fizdale.
No question about it. I think any move that happens with the Lakers organization, LeBron James has a say in it. David Fizdale is a LeBron guy. They had a close relationship during their time together in Miami. And it goes the same for the Jason Kidd hire, remember, because Jason Kidd and LeBron James also had a close relationship. So I think this fits the mold of what they – I think this is one of the boxes I was talking about earlier as far as an assistant head coach for the Lakers. They have to have a relationship with LeBron. Not every guy can do it. We've seen coaches before in the past fail when it came to his relationship with LeBron. So having David Fizdale there to kind of bridge the gap between LeBron and the rest of the coaching staff, I think, is crucial. So I think that's going to be a factor in this hiring. As far as like how big of a factor it is, I can't really say for certain, but it definitely was a factor in this hiring for sure.
And then lastly, what we're waiting for now is an extension for current Lakers head coach Frank Vogel. We've heard that's been in the works for, well, literally months at this point. Still has not happened. Maybe they were waiting for this domino to figure it out. But you know what? The Lakers, when Vogel came in, they made sure they stocked his bench with people who had head coaching experience. Lionel Hollins, Jason Kidd, right now turning to David Fizdale. Do you read anything into that? Is this just the Lakers want a lot of just smart basketball minds on the bench? Or is this, hey, in case things don't work out with Vogel, we want to have fallback options already in the program?
I can't imagine that Vogel there's any threat to Vogel's position. He's won an NBA title just as recently as last year. I know there hasn't been an extension yet, which to me is still a little odd, but I do think that the two sides are going to end up negotiating a deal and he'll be here long term. So I don't really read too much into David Fizdale potentially taking Vogel's job at all, but I think they do place a premium on previous head coaching experience. I think they want as many, like you said, smart minds in the basketball room when they're going over game plans and other things of that nature. And again, I think it's helpful to have someone like Fizdale who's, you know, not maybe been a successful head coach, but has been a successful assistant head coach. So I think that's just really the thinking there. I wouldn't read too much into David Fizdale possibly going to take over Vogel's job anytime soon.
Fair enough. Yeah, I see it the same way. It just is interesting that they're finding guys who have previous head coaching experience, and Vogel's contract extension is still kind of up in the air at this point. But the general tone from the Lakers organization has been, look, it was external factors that caused the Lakers to get bounced out of the playoffs this year, being the injuries, the compressed schedule, the quick turnaround, all of those sort of things combining to create an unfortunate season that saw the Lakers go out in the first round. I don't think they're blaming Coach Frank Vogel for that right now. So, but I do think it's a big hire for the Lakers, bringing in somebody with the kind of experience that Fizdale has. The relationship, obviously, with LeBron James, also very, very important. But Lakers Nation, let us know what you think about the Lakers turning to David Fizdale to fill out their bench. Fire it off in the comments down below. Don't forget to subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel and ring that notification bell as well. Till next time, stay safe and see ya.